Today, we are talking about the restocking activities on turb. My presentation is divided into 7 parts. Let's start the first title, basic of restocking. As you know, restocking activities couldn't be random. It should depend scientific rules. In this point, GFCM prepared a guideline on aquaculture restocking and stock enhancement. In this guideline, the increasing production of commercial species, and enhancement programs to aid recovery of endangered species. Then stocking enhancements or supplements self-requiring populations. Restoration practices where capacity to expand stocks naturally has been lost because of destruction of spawning grounds or loss of ecosystem community. Let's continue with the general principles. We are mentioned about the general principles. With restocking or releasing activities for marine stock enhancement from farmed fish species, the following main principles and data recording monitoring chain should be considered. Restocking and stock enhancement activities should be species specific. Restocking and stock enhancement programs with non-native species should be prohibited. Then, restocking and stock enhancement activities should be based on the aquaculture knowledge and assessment of the stock considered. A good knowledge of species biology and ecology should be supported by research activities on these species, including a management and monitoring program. Aquaculture condition should be very well known and proven in terms of technologies applied. Restocking and stock enhancement programs, in particular, if referred to shared stocks, should be based upon scientific cooperation among different institutions from the countries concerned. The preparation of specific species-specific guidelines for marine restocking and stock enhancement activities from farmed fish would be useful to address responsible aquaculture and fisheries activities. So, let's move on to turbot seed production for releasing. The origin of the broodstock for breeding purposes should be based on specimen coming from the local population to ensure the genetic consistency between hatchery juveniles and the wild stock. And a rotational broodstock selection strategy should be adapted to ensure that a full genetic variability within regional populations is accessed. In conclusion, of juveniles released from the hatchery, is subsequent broodstock capture should be avoided. A biodiversity plan and health management plan for broodstock and juveniles, including disease testing and health certification, should be available. As you see the picture, the left one, the capture turbot with gill net, and after taking the hatchery, we control it, and then if it is suitable for spawning, and then we use their eggs. In this process, quality egg and sperm use. The family produced separated in this time. Then fertilized eggs to be incubated. Until hatching time. Yes, juvenile qualities for releasing include 4 subtitles. One is the elimination of abnormal fishes. The other one, disease control and tagging. And the last one is the adaptation before releasing. When we mentioned, when we talk about the elimination of abnormal fishes, prior to release, the genetic variability of hatchery produce juveniles should be assessed against the natural populations, inhibiting the surrounding of the target area. To preserve the genetic diversity for sustainable restocking and stock enhancement actions, for example, DNA fingerprinting at microsatellite loci to assess genetic variability of rock stocks and F1 juveniles in comparison to natural population, etc. It should be assessed the morphological quality of hatchery juveniles to evaluate the presence of skeletal anomalies and anomalies should be removed. I mentioned before the disease control is the very important part. The quality of fingerlings to be stocked should be wild-like and specimen should be guaranteed as pathogen-free. I mean, assessed by microbiological, pathological, and virological analyses before releasing. As you know, there are different tagging methods. Generally, we use in our institute the plastic ones. These plastic ones, you see the left upper left side. How can we take the turbot? We use dorsal line and near the dorsal fin, we use the gun, and there is some numbers for the individual, and then tagging with individuals. This is the method which is generally used. If you have to mass tagging, you should use otoliths colorings. You can see here the otoliths coloring. In this coloring, we use the alizarin red and oxytetracycline chemical. After tagging, put the turbots for adaptation tank. We are stay them for a while for adaptation, and they release gently in the optimum place when time to go. So now we are come to releasing part. We ask here four questions. Where we releasing? When we are releasing, how can we do it, and which size of fish we use? First one is the juvenile turbots live especially in close coastal waters, rich environments by benthic organisms. These regions were preferred in the first place in terms of nutritional adaptation. We carefully this point before releasing and release the individuals between Hopa and Samsun coastal line. The Hopa is the here and the Sinop is the here in this Black Sea coastal line. When fish reach to between 5 and 10 gram, it means they are ready to releasing. Then the most optimum period for fisheries is fall, September, October, and November period. The other periods during the year are not ideal due to both natural conditions affecting growth in the ecosystem, protection of offspring populations from commercial networks, and increased growth in the crops. The turbot with an average length 13.9 centimeter and a body weight of 59.8 grain is used. Now we see here the black box. We mentioned, we talk about the first slides, how can we take the broodstock and then taking them to the hatchery. This is nursery center, then take larvae and they grow and come to juvenile fish. Then when the time is come, they release to the sea, and then in this period, resource management use. There is some black box. We see the shape, survival and growth. We don't know predation and starvation subjects. We don't clear information about this. That's why those are the black box for us. And monitoring is very important after releasing turbot. We handle this monitoring subject in five parts. This program to trace the released fish should be developed, for example, by using molecular biological techniques, taking, etc. And implemented on a regular basis to assess the activities, effectiveness of restocking and stock enhancement actions. It means survival rate. A taking program is considered as appropriate for restocking and stocking enhancement activities. If implemented in close cooperation with fishers. You can see the left one, we contact our fishermen and if they take us our tagged individuals, tagged turbots, we give them the here's some gift for them for recapturing. The main purpose of recapture is to determine growth rate, migration, feeding, and reproductive behavior. Recapture and monitoring, estimation of dispersion pattern and fishing mortality, and possibly by using a questionnaire. Some questions we learned them, for example, dates, location, fishing gear, fish size, and weight information. Total recapture ratio is 2.2 percentage. In experimental studies on the same species in the world, the rate of return was found between 2 and 16 percentage. When we look at the migration line, it's depending on the age, condition, increase, horizontal and vertical migration, distance increase. The turbot population is a local migratory, turbot population is a migratory species, and the phenomenon of migration is up to about 60 kilometer. Migration is generally from west to east. The average horizontal migration distance is 25.4 kilometer, and the average migration depth is 29.6 meter. If we talking about the feeding behavior, we see the graph here. The adult, this is in Turkish yaş, it means 3 years. We see the graph, the turbot population predominantly shows a nutritional strategy linked to the whitening. This is whitening species. The length of turbot until 10 centimeters, they feed with crustaceans. After 10 centimeters, they start to feeding fish. Yes, here we see the growth rate and total length. Total length and weight graph. After the juvenile turbots are released into the sea, adaptation period is 2.5 months. During this period, the growth stops and they lose weight. After this adaptation period, they enter a rapid growth, we see here, and then process and their growth rate increased with age. We talked the reproduction. This is the reproduction time is the spring time for this species. Between April and June in Turkey. This is the our national turbot releasing program. This is very important for us. We use this program. We are depending on this program and the capture fisheries of turbot in the Black Sea is declining. So the introduction of measures of to reduce the fishing effort to the establishment of catch quota can in the long term improve the state of the resources. However, the natural regeneration is limits. Only an external contribution proves useful to restore equilibrium and speed up stock recovery. This contribution can only come from aquaculture. In Turkey, restocking of turbot originated from the awareness of the depletion of natural resource and a need conservation from stakeholders, public and private sectors. For this purpose, Turbot Stock Enhancement Program was launched in 1999 by Trabzon Central Fisheries Research Institute. In order to increase the recover the turbot stocks. In the scope of this program, 120,000 hatchery rate turbot species were individually tagged and released into the Black Sea until now. This program is still ongoing and every year regularly about 10,000 turbot are released into sea. The releasing of turbot is not only enhance the stock, but contributes to better understand biology, feeding behavior, migration pattern, etc. Of wild turbot through recaptured of them. The program is supported by all relevant stakeholders, especially fishers. You see here there are leaflets. And the the social program, social responsible program. In Turkish we say, benim dediğinizde bir balığım olsun. This is like slogan. In English, I may also have a fish in the sea. Lots of students come our institute and they release the take turbots. They contribute to these turbot stocks and they funny after this activity. And thank you very much.